Hello, Math students. This is Mr. Jacobs, and we're looking at 2.3 linear exponential. Or I'm going to scroll down to a section that I skipped. And here it is. There we go. So it says number 15. This linear exponential or neither. Let's take a look at that. So it says f of 1 equals 7. So I'm going to write this down as a table of values just to give you a feel for what it looks like. Now, f of 1 equals 7. That's what that means, input-output, right? F of 2 also equals 7. See that right there? 1, 7. 2, 7. Now, the recursive portion says f of n equals f of n minus 1 plus f of n minus 2. What's that mean? Well, it just means this. This is the previous term, and this is the term before the previous term. So this is so here we go. Let's find the next term. And so what I do there, the next term is f of 3, which means that the value of n equals 3. Hopefully you can see this. Let's move this out of the way. There you go. And that's what I was looking for. Let's take a good look. Apple 3. What is the value? Well, it's f of 2 plus f of 1. Well, f of 2 is 7. And f of 1 is 7, which is 14. And then you can continue with this process repeatedly. 4. F of 4 is f of 3 plus f of 2, which are these two numbers. You continue the process. F of 5 is 25. F of 6 is 56. So you now see that the output values are found by taking the previous and the term before the previous and summing those values. So that's how you find those outputs. Now when you look at those output values, 7, 7, 14, 21, 35, 56, there is no common difference or common ratio. So these are neither exponential or linear. So the answer is neither. This next one, 16, that create a table of values. F of 1 equals 1. F of 2, what that is. So Let's plug it in. So we know that n equals 1. So we're trying to find when n equals 2. So let's see what happens there. The answer is 2/3. And then, of course, after that, you're going to multiply by 2/3 again. That's what this means here. So we are multiplying the previous term to find the next term. We're multiplying by 2/3. So let's try that again. 2/3 times 2/3 is 4/9. 4/9 times 2/3 is 8/27, and so on and so forth. So when you're multiplying to find the next term, that is a common ratio. 2/3 is the common ratio, so we know this is going to be exponential. Right? Repeated multiplication to find the next term. And you also know that it's growing, right? It's this value is growing by a factor of 2/3. Now, actually, you know, no, it's not. It's actually shrinking because when you multiply by a number that's less than 1, the object gets smaller. So it's an exponential decay function. So that's how you set those up. Now, again, the tough part about that is looking at the recursive form and realizing whether or not it's exponential, neither or linear. So study that, think about it, and make sense of the material. So like always, study hard, learn a lot, and we will see you soon. Bye-bye.